was a kid, I was completely different than the rest of my classmates. My skin color was the one thing that stood out. And so I was, quote unquote, the victim of racism. And that caused me to have a very low opinion of myself. I just wanted to be the same. I changed my name. I wanted to fit in. And it wasn't until I developed later on that I looked back and I saw what the cause of some of the bullying was and the challenges that I was facing was simply a low sense of self-esteem. Had I known then what I know now, it would have saved me from a whole bunch of suffering. And so now, some of my patients are constantly coming to me and sharing with me some of the challenges that their teenagers are going through. And the big question that I get is, how do I get my kids to not really care about what other people think? You've all heard the phrase, love like you've never been hurt, sing like no one can hear, dance like no one's watching. What if we were to dance as though we know that everybody's watching, yet we don't care? What if you knew that life was all about people watching you, making judgments regardless, but you didn't care and you danced anyway? We're gonna go and dance as though we're being watched, but we don't really care.
Minute, hour, bigger, better, stronger, power.
When you are dancing and you are expressing who you really are, you're going to be judged. People are going to think you're good, people are going to think you're bad, people are going to have their opinions, they're going to think you look like an idiot sometimes. But dance like you don't care who's watching. Not dance like no one's watching. Dance like you know if there's 1,000 people watching you, they're judging you, they're going to say yay or nay, but you don't care. That make to my soul. Hate to bust your bubble. I'm on that other level. I'ma take it higher and bring it higher and higher. I stay in fire, tire. Keep burning like that fire.
Takes a lot of courage.
It's got some sweet moves.
Makes me want to dance.
I thought he was dorky and weird. I mean, I want to do that, but I don't want to make a fool of myself.
People with similar values to you are giving you one of these. People with values that are not similar to you are giving you one of these.
If they don't pay my rent, I don't care.
Whether you are bullied or you're being bullied, low self-esteem is the underlying root cause. It's the ones with low self-esteem that actually want to push other people around as well. So low self-esteem is the underlying root cause of the bully and the bullied.
I was dealing with things so much better and so much easier. And then when I went and thought about it, I was like, oh, it's because of the things Dr. Nima has been telling me.
In a lot of situations, I just didn't have the tools or knowledge on how to deal with certain situations.
If we teach the kids how to get to the root cause of their problems, low self-esteem is probably the root cause of most conflicts, both inner and external. And if we catch that problem and understand it and give kids tools in how to transcend it, then we're actually becoming part of the solution rather than trying to eliminate a problem.
I walked out and it was just like the weight of the world had been lifted off my shoulders. Like it was, I could breathe again. Like how you talked earlier today about the like clench in your stomach, and it's like relaxed, gone.
I really don't think I would have been this okay as I am right now if I didn't know his knowledge.
If you're truly expressing who you are, that will challenge some people. And most people are not prepared for that.
One time for